Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm showing you my favorite and the best of Initio parfum privé. So this is a French house, and I have to say I've been talking a lot about Oud for Greatness, like the star of the range, I would say. I wanted to dive into the brand and to give you, for me, which are the best and the one you should try first if you're discovering the brand. I've got from the half little sprays, and I've got a discovery set that is, oh my god, so beautiful. You can just open it like this and typical. So I had an occasion to try all the fragrance of Initio, and I'm gonna give you my top five. It was really difficult. Like, for the fifth position, I'm quite pretty sure that its place is here, but the rest was so difficult, and really they're just very, very amazing. But let me tell you about it now. Initio in Latin words means the origin, like the creation, and it's something that is there to initiate you to fragrance. The philosophy of the brand is that fragrance can give you power, just like before with the Egyptian, fragrance was used as power. So it can give you confidence, create some magic, and attract love as well. Number five. Very difficult to find, and trust me, this one you would probably be surprised of my choice for the number 5th, Atomic Rose. I'm not really a rose lover, but if the rose is nicely blended and surprised me, then I really like it. First time I smelled that, I was like, ooh, too much rose, and then I really had it on my skin, and I started to really, really love this rose. What I like is at the beginning is really like a bomb, an explosion of rose, but it's a fresh rose. So it's not the vintage one that is a bit like, smell like old petals of rose. It's not something that is smelling extremely sweet. No, 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 it's a very modern rose. There's got a touch of citrus with bergamot and everything that give projection to the rose, so it makes it like a light one, even though you've got two different roses, which is Turkish rose and Bulgarian rose. So it's a mix of very powerful roses, but because they're blended with the citrus, give like a light projection. So it's really a bomb, but it's a fresh bomb of flowers. Even though it's got a citrus vibe, it's a fragrance that is very smooth and really good for winter, because it's not like a fresh scent you can pull out when it's very hot. For me, it's fresh but still have some heaviness on the skin. It settles more in vanilla, so it settles in like a warm oriental, very beautiful. Number 4 is Psychedelic Love. So that's where it started to be a bit blurred for me. Like, all the ones that are coming is fragrance that I really, really, really enjoy, so it was difficult for me to categorize them in a list. But anyway, Psychedelic Love, because it's a narcotic bomb. It makes me think of the 70s spirit, when everything was legal, I would say. Song of the Velvet Underground. If you never listened to the Velvet Underground, listen to Heroin and you will understand this fragrance a bit more. It's mesmerizing. There's a lot of like bright floral note with ylang ylang, gourmand tone as well, so slightly gourmand and slightly medicinal as well. Touch of myrrh mixes with some citrus. It's very strange, it's difficult to describe, but the idea is something completely out of this planet, mesmerizing. Charlie, what are you doing? Mysterious. If you want to give like a very unique, mysterious way, you're gonna like that. It's strong, it's creamy, it's slightly more woodier with the time as well. When you apply it to your skin, at least to me, it went a bit more woodier with the time. A very powdery vibe. That's why it's so mysterious, cloudy. The opening is very floral. You got something very powdery, and it dries down is something a bit more woody. So it's a very interesting fragrance. But again, I will ask you like to try it on your skin because it's so different from person to person. And one of my favorite scents is Rehab. Oh my God. What I like with Initial is they choose the name very carefully. Rehab is perfect for it because it sounds like a opulent medicine for your soul. If you like barbershop fragrance, spicy barbershop, you're gonna enjoy that. There's a lot of lavender, so it's very soothing. So it looks like you've been partying too hard and you have you go to rehab and you have this intense soothing tone. It's strong enough to disintoxicate you, and I so love it. I think it's so relaxing, but it's a bomb again. A lot of powderiness. Very velvety. So velvety when you touch. It's nearly like you can touch the softness of it. A lot of people been comparing it to Spice Bomb from Victorian Wolf, which I kind of agree. There's something like it, but I think this is much more refined. There's not this really synthetic touch. It's so creamier, so detailed, so contrasted. Oh my God. Feel a lot of softness, tenderness, and coziness with it. And for me, the star ingredient for me is the vanilla. Very green tone. That's why I think men are quite easily more drawn to Rehab, because it suits a lot of men with this green. And okay, so a lot of people are gonna be like, what? I always said that my favorite will be Oud for Greatness. So my number two is actually Oud for Greatness. Surprising to see it in number two? Yes, okay. This is pure luxury, very heaviness. What I like with this oud is it's not a backbone. You can really, really smell it. There's a bit of this animalic tone that is here, but it's perfectly balanced with the lavender that gives a bit like a medicinal tone, really relaxing, but in a good way. It's in a good way. A spicy nutmeg that is here to give thickness to the fragrance. Patchouli, so it's quite greener. The oud is really present, and it gives a bit like of sugariness as well. Slightly sugary tone, and this is giving by the saffron. Saffron always give like a bitter sugariness to a fragrance, and it's there to give like a bit more luxury. It smells luxury when you smell it. This fragrance got a projection that is completely crazy. But to be honest, all of them, it's got a really strong projection and are very, very long lasting. Like, it's so long lasting, my heart, my soul, oh my God. It's got a musky tone, so again, it's quite powdery, spicy, animalic, but at the same time soothing. So it's a perfect oud fragrance for me, and that's why I think it got so many good critique. And I just love it. I think it's got so much character, so much sexiness. This is so sexy, but overall, all of them are so, so sexy. I would say things like Psychedelic Love, Rehab are more sensual, but this is extremely, extremely sexy. Oh my God, like if you want to show off and impress, Oud for Greatness. Number one, and I was really surprised, was like, I'm sure my number one is going to be Oud for Greatness. No, no. It's not, but it's, you know, they are slightly on the same level to me, but I really had a crush on Side Effect. I just love it. If you're looking for a tobacco that is really unique, oh my God, Side Effect! Tobacco, vanilla, lots of rum, so it's slightly boozy, but not too much, and you've got a touch of cinnamon to be quite spicy. What I like is it's quite bright. Overall, it's a really dark fragrance, heavy and sexy. It's got a bright undertone. It's like a light in the darkness that I think is really amazing, and the contrast between the two is absolutely stunning. It's got a bit of a cherry vibe, so when I smell it, I can smell something a bit more fruity, cherry-like. So I know they're not inside, but I can smell it. Very addictive. It's nearly like vampiric. It's like a bit like a vampire, like it's catching you. Smooth. It's really gourmand, really, really gourmand. A bit heavy, boozy. It's beautiful, honestly beautiful. On the skin, it's projecting as well, but compared to the other one, stays very close to the skin and gives like a smoothiness and something extremely addictive. And I felt fascinated with this fragrance because at the beginning I could really smell all this vanilla touch and everything that was really present, but with the time you get more this tobacco dried down, a bit more earthy, and I really, really love that. Yesterday, I took a shower, and you know, like, after I go out of the shower, I spray something on me, because it's where the projection is the best. If you want something very long-lasting, put it after you showered, right after the shower, and it's gonna stay very long. So I've put that after the shower a lot over there, and I was just, you know, moving around. I was lighting a candle, that's what I do before I go to bed, lighting the candle, all projected. I was like, what I'm smelling, it was all around me, like I could really, really, really smell it. And I was just like, oh my god, that's me smelling now. But it was not smelling like the vanilla scent I spray at the beginning. It was those tobacco, warm, deep darkness. And I was just like, oh, absolutely mind-blowing, mind-blowing. But like, especially like, for me, my favorite one are Rehab Side Effect Oud for Greatness. That's the one I really, really enjoy the most. Oh, crazy. If you're looking for something unique, dark and extremely sexy, give you character, you want everyone to smell you, but not like you're gonna, well, you're gonna probably intoxicate a lot of people, to be honest. You want to give a great impression. For me, Inisho, mind-blowing. For me, one of the best niche house existing at the moment. Really, really great fragrance. Like, I mean, I'm really, really impressed. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you want to leave me a little comment to tell me which one is your favorite, leave me a little like, because it helped me as well to reference my video. Subscribe to my channel, of course, if you didn't subscribe. Like, please, it's free. Like, I won't spam you, I promise. Maybe just a little bit. Thank you everyone that give me a contribution on my Utip account in the description box. Really helping me. It's really, really nice and comforting. It's really boosting me. So thank you so much. And yeah, I will see you very soon in another review. Bye now.